Hello guys, welcome back to NC-II. So yung nakaraan, pinag-usapan natin yung motherboard at CPU. So in continuation po in our assembled computer hardware, pag-uusapan naman po natin yung storage. Okay? So wag natin patagalin. Let's continue this discussion and review in assembled computer hardware. Okay, so as mentioned, nasa computer hardware po tayo, part ng UC-1. So, in the previous discussion po, sa mga hindi nakapanood ng mga previous videos, ito po yung pinag-usapan namin. So, sa ngayon, nandito na po kami sa storage or memory. Okay? So, let's continue. And, storage. So, storage or memory storage. So, it's called a memory storage is a device used to store data or programs on a temporary or permanent basis for use in a electronic digital computer. So, importante pong malaman natin itong storage or meron kayong essential knowledge patungkol sa storage. Kasi during assembled a computer hardware, may mga storage devices na kasama dun. So, much better din na naiintindihan natin yun. Okay? So, there are types of storage devices. The first one is the optical storage devices. So, some example of these are CD-ROM and DVD-ROM and Blu-ray. Okay? So, another example of storage devices or type of storage devices are magnetic. So, there are magnetic storage devices. Example of these storage devices in magnetic are HDD. So, yan, HDD. Meron din tayong floppy disk and magnetic tape. Another type of storage devices is flash memory, SSD. Example nito. And meron din USB flash drive at SD card. So, yung gagawin natin is pag-uusapan natin isa-isa itong mga type na storage devices para mas maintindihan ninyo. Okay? So, let's start with the optical storage devices. So, CD-ROM stand for compact drive read-only memory. Okay? And DVD-ROM stand for digital versatile disk read-only memory. And Blu-ray, all Blu-ray lang rin. Wala siyang ibang stand sa name niya, acronym. So, yung differences lang nitong mga optical drive nito is a matter of the storage capacity and the quality they can handle. So, yung CD drive or compact drive, medyo maliit yung storage capacity niya and then mas malaki din yun sa DVD drive. Tapos, dun naman din sa Blu-ray, mas upgraded siya ng DVD ROM. Okay? So, nothing special with the optical drive. It's just an upgraded version from CD to DVD and the Blu-ray. So, kadalasan nating naririnig yung mga ganito pag bumibili tayo sa bangketa ng mga illegal na CD. Tapos, sinatanong, ano yan? Blu-ray na ba yan? HD na ba? Ganun. Kasi, pag DVD kasi, yung quality ng image na pwede niya i-handle is medyo maling. Like sa Blu-ray, pwede na mga HD na. So, mga high definition na yung kayang i-handle ng Blu-ray. Like 1080, 1920, yung ganun. So, in CD and DVD-ROM, may tinatawag ito na media recordable and read and write. So, yung sa media or in some terms na ginagamit is readable. So, yung media na to, eto, minsan tinatawag tong readable. So, pag readable lang, kung anong laman ng CD or DVD, automatically binabasa nila. And another type nila is itong recordable. So, ibig sabihin, wala siyang laman. Tapos, once na nag-record kayo or you write something in that optical drive or optical storage, hindi nyo na pwedeng baguhin. So, yung third version nila is itong read-write. So, may nilalagay kayo tapos pwede nyo pang i-modify. So, that's are the somehow type of optical drives in CD and DVD. Okay? So, by definition, optical drive refer to a storage in an electronic storage medium that use lower power laser beams to record additive digital binary data. In optical storage technology, a laser beam encodes digital data onto an optical or laser disk in a form of tiny bits arranged in a spiral track of the disk surface. So, kung mapapansin nyo, yung disk pabilog, kaya yun, optical laser din yung ginagamit to encode the data in a disk. So, by definition po, yung ginagamit nila is yung lower power laser beams to record and retrieve the data. So, yan. Now, let's go with the magnetic storage devices. So, magnetic storage devices, marami po siyang klase, pero commonly yung alam natin is itong HDD or hard disk drive. Yung floppy disk at magnetic tape, hindi ko alam kung nabutan niyo pa to, pero noon ginagamit to, and it can handle a small amount of data. So, kadalasan, until now, yung ginagamit na lang na marinig yung magnetic na storage devices, itong HDD. Marami pa pong ibang magnetic storage devices pero hindi ko na sinali kasi nakafocus lang ako dito sa commonly na naririnig pa natin in our generation. So, by definition po, magnetic storage or magnetic recording is the storage of data on a magnetic medium. Magnetic storage is different pattern of magnetization in magnetizable materials to store data is a form of non-multi memory. Those type of data saved in that medium in a binary form like zeros and ones. So, napapansin nyo po dito, sige po ng konti. Yan, so ito, ito yung head niya, ito yung ginagamit to read what inside the magnetic disk. So, yan. Later on, I will show it to you the parts of that magnetic. So, during assemble and disassemble computer hardware, lagi nyo pong na-encounter tong HDD, so please keep that in mind. And flash memory. So flash memory is a electronic non-volatile computer memory, katulad sila ng SSD, HDD. Storage medium that can be electrically erased and deprogrammed. The two main types of flash memory is NOR flash and NAND flash are named before NOR and NAND logic gates. NOR and NAND flash use the same cell design consisting of the 14 gate MOSFET. So, yung NOR and flash gate, huwag mo masyadong i-overthink at just the two types of flash memory na ginagamit to record yung 0 and 1s or data. So, in today's generation po, this flash memory, kadalasan yun ang nakikita na gagamit. So, unlike those previous example or type of the storage devices. So, sa ngayon, in some laptops and even a desktop, gumagamit na sila ng flash memory like SSD. So, pertaining to SSD, marami din klase may M.2 PCI. Pero, hindi ko na sinali. Ito lang common na magagamit natin during assemble a computer hardware. So, if you want to have a comparison between the HDD, SSD, and M.2, yung mga ganon, comment nyo lang sa below kasi gagawa natin ng content kung kailangan nyo talaga. However, our objective here is just to have a basic knowledge in particular storage devices in order for us to assemble the computer hardware. So again, these are the flash memory na na-encounter natin. So yung USB flash drive, yung known sa atin, it is ito din, an SD card. And marami pa pong flash memory, hindi lang po itong tatlo. Ito just a common example that I know that I'm just showing to you, everyone. So, going back. So, kanina, we're just discussing about the storage devices. So, ngayon naman po, we're going to tackle the computer memory. So, in computer memory, yun yung mga data na ginagamit natin or part ng computer kung saan doon natin nilalagay at kinukuha or manipulate yung data. So, in computer memory, by definition, computer memory is the storage space in a computer. So, yung computer na binubuo natin or i-assemble natin or disassemble natin, where data is to be processed and instruction required for processing are stored. The memory in is divided into large number of small parts called cells. Each location of cells has unique address, which varies from 0 to memory size minus 1. So, yung nangyayari po sa memory ng computer, ito po yung process nila at by definition, ito po yun. So, huwag nyo masyadong i-overthink. Yung sa atin lang, alam natin pag computer memory, dyan nag-i-store or naglalagay ng data si computer. Okay? At at the same time, dyan na rin pinaprocess yung mga instruction na kailangan. Okay? So, there are two types of computer memory, no? And it's divided into two. So, yan. Memory, may tinatawag tayong primary memory. So, kadalasan ng primary memory are volatile. Okay? Kadalasan, hindi lahat. Okay? So, noon, tinatawag itong main memory. So, nilagay ko na rin sa baba. Baka may encounter kayo na ganyang terminology. A quick overview regarding the primary memory. It also considers sa internal memory, and the CPU can access directly or access directly by CPU. So, next one is the secondary memory. Most of the secondary memory is non-volatile. So, hindi basta-basta nasisira, yung ganyan, hindi masyadong fragile. And before, tinatawag din itong auxiliary. And secondary memory is also considered as external memory. And as mentioned, secondary memory is a long-term storage of data. So, may mga data kayo na pang matagalan, dyan nyo kadalasan ilalagay. Okay? So, hopefully that is clear, the type of memory. Then, para mas maintindihan natin, let's jump in kung ano bang definition ng primary memory. And then, we yung follow to secondary memory. So, primary memory primary memory, this is a section of CPU that holds program instruction, input data, and intermediate result. It is generally smaller in size. Example nito is RAM and ROM, for example of primary storage. So, as mentioned before, no? So, CPU have instruction or program. So, kadalasan yun nilalagay niya sa RAM or sa ROM, or minsan nire-retrieve niya sa RAM or sa ROM. So, depende. So, in short po, yung ina-access ng CPU is yung mga primary memory storage. Okay? I'll give you the example of primary storage para may idea naman po kayo. The example of primary memory. So, RAM, as mentioned earlier, RAM stands for Random Access Memory. It is used to store information that is used immediately, or when can you say that is in temporary memory. Compute bring the software installed on the hard disk to RAM to process it and to be used by the user. Once the computer is turned on, the data is deleted. So sa RAM po kasi, na-mention dito, pansin nyo, na-mention dito, highlight ko, yung computer bring software installed on a hard disk. So, ibig po sabihin dito, yung mga na-install nyo na software application sa hard disk, pinaprocess dun sa RAM yung ibang data na kailangan. No, yung mga data usually na ginagamit ng user. Pero once the computer is turned off, the data is deleted. So, yun yung nangyayari sa RAM. So, hindi siya pwedeng lagyan ng permanent kasi nga, consider siya as volatile. Okay? So, there are types of RAM. So, tinatawag siyang static RAM access memory, dynamic random access memory, and synchronistic RAM access memory. So, hindi ko na siya isahin. That will be your assignment. But, from the added word sa RAM, it can be, pwede nyo siya maintindihan pag nawag static, pag nawag dynamic, and synchronous. Okay? So, again, that's are the type of RAM. Okay? So, para may idea kayo kung anong hitsura ng RAM, ito po siya. So, yan po yung RAM. Nakikita nyo. Yung maliit, kadalasan nilalagay yan sa laptop. Yung malaki, kadalasan sa desktop na PC ko. Okay? So, in our assembled computer hardware, kadalasan dyan sa mga training center, etong, saan ba yung pointer? Etong malaki yung ginagamit. Okay? or mas mahaba. Next example of primary memory is the ROM, or stand for read-only memory. The data written or stored in this device are non-verified. So, as I said, hindi lahat ng primary memory are volatile. Some are non-volatile. Once the data is stored in the memory, it cannot be modified or deleted. The memory from which the blah 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 blah. So, ibig po sabihin dito, yung ROM is meron na siyang stored na data from manufacturer po. So, ito. Ito pala. So, manufacturer once, only once. So, may instruction na dun na yun yung kinukuha ni CPU. So, yun, bawal nyo po yan burahin. So, pwede lang siyang basahin. Kaya tinawag siyang read only. So, by definition nyo po, maiintindihan nyo na kung bakit tinawag siyang read only. So, next naman are the types of ROM. So, merong programmable at merong erasable programmable. So, yung yan, so there are two types of ROM. So kadalasan yung nasa computer memory yung ginagamit is itong PROM or programmable read only memory. So bawal yung erasable programmable. So kadalasan na ROM hindi na natin nagugura. So in some cases sa mga industry iba ginagamit din lang is EPI ROM, pero diyan sa i-assemble natin wala na kayong iintindihan kasi most of the ginagamit sa CSS is yung PROM lang. Okay? So, these are the example or images of ROM. So, meron pahaba, meron din pa sulok, or yung iba rectangle. Okay? So, another example of primary memory is CMOS. Actually, CMOS is part of the RAM. I just want to emphasize this thing because during assemble, yung objective natin, or disassemble computer hardware, kadalasan natatouch po yung CMOS battery. At may cases din po na kailangan siyang mag-replace. So at least alam nyo na pwede siyang matanggal or part of assemble and disassemble. So by definition, CMOS is alternatively referred to the RTC or real-time clock. So ito talaga yung oras, literal na oras. Yung sa previous video po, ibang clock po yung pinag-usapan natin. And NVRAM or non-volatile RAM or CMOS RAM. So CMOS is short for complementary metal oxide semiconductor. So I want to highlight this one, no? Yung meaning ng CMOS. So keep this thing in mind kasi minsan tinatanong to. Yan. Complementary metal oxide semiconductor. CMOS is an onboard battery powered semiconductor chip inside the computers that store information. Yung information dyan, yung oras po. So, ito po yung example ng CMOS battery. Ayan, pabilog po siya. Okay? Next is the secondary memory. Secondary memory is a storage or is a memory that is stored external to the computer. It's mainly used for the permanent and long-term storage programs and data. So, dito nyo po sinasave yung mga application nyo, yung mga files nyo, and etc. Okay? So, let's discuss the example of secondary memory. So, secondary memory, yung pinakauna na mention natin is hard disk drive. It is a storage device that store and retrieves data using magnetic storage. It's non-volatile storage device that can modify or delete N numbers of time. So, yung ibig sabihin pala ng N numbers yung time dito is pwede maraming beses, no? So, somehow, in infinite times. So, hindi lang sinabing infinite kasi somehow, mag-error din kasi yan due to bad sectors. Pero hindi natin itatakal yan ngayon kasi we're talking just about the example of secondary memory. So, kadalasan sa i-assemble natin na computer or disassemble or kahit sa mga store ng computer shop, lagi nyo itong na-encounter itong hard disk drive. So, knowing what is the function and what is the purpose of this will give you the advantage. Okay? You can easily explain to your client or to your student somehow or to someone who want to know about this thing kung para saan to at anong pwedeng gawin nito. Okay? So, these are the parts of the HDD. So, meron siyang head, equator, arm, axis. So, if we're going to discuss more on HDD, kaka-integration ng malaking oras. So we're just explaining the example of secondary memory. So tackling this thing required more time. Kaya yan, image lang po muna. Tapos try natin to zoom in para makita nyo yung parts kung gusto nyo malaman talaga. So ito yung read, write, head, and yung ginagamit. So hopefully kung gusto nyo ma-explain to, just comment lang below, sir. Gusto ko ma-explain yung HTD and more about HTD yan. So we're going to make a content about that thing or about discussion about this thing, okay? So, yan. Another example of secondary memory is solid state drive. So a mass storage device like HDDs. So magkatulad sila ng HDD ng function. Pero this time, itong solid state drive, wala siyang disk. It's more durable because it does not contain optical disk yun. Sinabi ko kanina, wala siyang optical sticks inside. It needs less power as compared to hard disk. It's lightweight and has 10 faster. So, dahil wala na siyang disk na kailangan paikit-kutin o kailangan pang, anong tawag nito, hintayin na dumating sa point para mabasa. So, mas mabilis po yung solid state drive. So, kadalasan ng mga servers, gaming, computers, yung mga pang-video at tapos pang-photo editing, kadalasan yung ginagamit nila is ito ng solid state drives because of fast transferring and rewriting the data. Okay? So, let's proceed! By the way, ito po pala, bago tayo mag-proceed, ito po pala yung part ng SSD. So, na-mention natin kanina yung mga design or how the SSD work in a flash memory. Ito yung NAND at meron ding NOR. So, yung ginagamit niya is NAND. So, ayan, controller and cache. So, hindi ko to i-discuss once again because we are just here to give you the example of secondary memory. So, kung gusto nyo po, gawin natin ang content. And comment nyo lang po kung may gusto po para naman po magawa natin. And we can discuss and explore more about the SSD or comparison ng M.2 at ng iba pang mga flash memories. Okay? So, going back to the example of secondary memory, ito yung pinaka-latest na alam ko na secondary memory is the cloud or virtual storage. So, we can store our files and other stuff in the cloud and data stored for as long as we pay our cloud storage. So, are many companies that provides Google services cloud. There are many companies that provide cloud services, largely Google, Amazon, Microsoft, and etc. Yan po yung mga example na our type of memory. So, sa ngayon po kasi, napapansin natin yung mga files natin, pwede natin save sa online, pwede natin i-transfer doon, and nandun na sila palagi. Tapos kung gusto natin i-access, as long as we have the internet, are able to access. So, yung iba din, yung nagsiserver na ng data, nasa cloud din. So, if you want to discuss more about cloud storage, again, it's just an example kaya hindi ko madi-discuss to you literally kung ano talaga yan and we cannot expound more about that. So, if you want, i-comment nyo lang sa baba, sir, make this one a content and gagawan ko po na explanation para po sa inyo. Okay? By the way, cloud storage is not part of the assemble and disassemble. And during assemble and disassemble a computer, we're not going to store some data in our virtual storage. Kaya, yan, chill lang tayo. Ito po pala yung image ng virtual storage. Yan yun po yung nangyayari. So, another example of secondary memory is ito. So, hindi ko na isa-isahin. Just to mention, SD card, memory card, multimedia, optical storage. Yung optical storage devices, na-mention natin yung mga CDs kanina. So, that's it. Yeah? Yun lang po yung storages. I hope you learn something. And before we end, as usual po, gusto ko munang mag-conduct ng brain check. Kasi po, just to make sure that you're able to identify, you know, the function and hindi nyo nakakalimutan. It will also help you, no, na mas maalala pa yung mga dapat maalala. Okay? So, I'll give you a minute to check your brain if you able to retain the topic. So, ito po yung gagawin. So, I believe, rename mo na yung video. video kasi tapos mo ng salagatan at so, na-review mo na rin, okay? So mga katambay, yun lang po sa ngayon. As mentioned po, yung pag-uusapan natin sa about storage. So next video na i-upload ko is patungkol naman po sa safety protocols, tools, and documents. So hopefully nakasubaybay po rin po kayo. Please do not hesitate to hit the notification bell para ma-aware po kayo pag nag-upload po ako ng panibagong video patungkol sa assembled computer hardware. Just keep in mind, pagkatapos ko pong i-discuss tong topic lahat from common components to the tools and documents, i-upload ko na po yung demonstration in disassembling and assembling a computer hardware. At the same time po, bibigyan po ako ng tips and safety tips and mga tips na pwede nyo din pong magamit sa